paper and I started to draw a picture, but all those shapes and sketchy lines, not what I had in my mind, so I tried making it a movie, all black and white and kinda moody. The actors were all friends of mine, the dialogue was improvised. Editing it, it wasn't happy because it had turned out kinda crap. Here's a video, just was wrong, so I thought I'd make it a song. It started out as a song, but all the chords I played wrong, and the lyrics were all boring, so I thought I'd make it a drawing. So I got out a pen and paper and I started to draw a picture, but all those shapes and sketchy lines, not what I had in my mind, so I tried making it a movie, all black and white and kinda moody. The actors were all friends of mine, the dialogue was improvised. Editing it, I wasn't happy because it had turned out kinda crappy. As a video, just was wrong, so I thought I'd make it a song. It started out as a song, but all the chords I played wrong, and the lyrics were all boring, so I thought I'd make it a drawing. I want to do everything and then forget it. And I want to do everything and then forget it. I was gonna make you some tea, but by the time you get to me, it will be cold. I was gonna make you some food, but by the time I get to you, it will be covered in mold, and there's nothing I can do to make this land between us smooth. And there's nothing I can say that won't sound dumb from far away, from your house to my gate. The road, it may seem straight, but lying in between are too many rocks and trees. And I was gonna write you a song, but the distance someone travels is not very long. And I guess I could write you a letter, and I know that will get to you, but I know I could do better, and there must be something I can do to make this land between us smooth. Because everything you say just makes the distance fade away. So fuck those rocks and trees, and we'll hang out in between. Build tree houses by day, and by night explore the caves. Sky I'll never know because he's dead. And his name was Burton Holmes and now he's dead. And he travelled around the world making videos, and he sold them at his shows, but now he's dead. And with a camera in my hand, oh, I tried making videos. And I walked down to the bus stop and gave travelling a go. I saw London in the sun and I saw Bristol in the snow. And I saw my pockets empty and I had to go back home. Lately I have hated every video I've made, and travelling on holidays just doesn't feel the same. And I've been thinking of just setting off and getting on a plane to LA, California, to find Burton Holmes' grave. standing on his skeleton and looking at his stone. I'll see he lived for almost 80 years while I'm just 21, and so I guess it doesn't matter that I'm still getting things wrong, cause really I'm still growing up and the best is yet to come. Doesn't matter that Burton Holmes is dead, cause others carry on for him instead. And people still play shows and make videos and they still travel around the world, they're not dead. Okay, can I do that again? Balloons escape from the fair, 100 civilians looking into the air. A nice time Stockton slowed down, its laws no longer applied, as folks stared at the balloons getting higher in the sky. No one said anything, nobody made a sound, until every last balloon had disappeared in the clouds. The time started back up again in this usual fashion, everyone moved on as if nothing could happen. But what do the balloons do when they go into space? Do they implode, do they explode, do they stay in one place? Do they fly all around and hang with other lost balloons? Or do they keep their head down and get caught up on the balloons? Photographs put on the net so that 100 people would never forget about the time they saw all those balloons appear and then disappear at 9:15. The moment was magic like you'd see on TV, a symbolic moment to break up the story. But they are not subless balloons of stories of their own, and they don't cease to exist just because of where they've flown. So what do the balloons do when they go into space? Do they implode, do they explode, do they stay in one place? Do they fly all around and hang with other lost balloons? Or do they keep their head down and get caught up on the moon? About it, I don't really want to know. I'm just happy looking upwards, watching them fly to some great ruling mystery that resides above the sky. Maybe when I die, I will reincarnate, and I'll come back as a balloon and find out where they migrate. Maybe when I get there, I'll look down on the ground and ask myself another question that is just as profound, like, where do all those bubbles go when they disappear? Do they go forward in time to a far away year? What do stars think about as they sit in space? Do they ever get lonely? Do they ever feel afraid? And you know those monsters that live under your bed? What happens to their bodies after they're dead? And where do pencil lines go after they've been erased? And what do the balloons do when they go into space? Got a box, and it's not much to look at, and it smells of an old cat, and the edges of it are starting to rot. You've got a box, and it's made of solid gold, and it doesn't look too old, and it's everything, oh, that my box is not. And in my box is everything I've ever known, and it shows just how I've grown into who I am. And in your box, well, it's similar to mine, except everything inside it brightly shines. I don't care that I'm carrying a box of broken parts, cause I regard the things inside as little works of art. And underneath the sellotape there are great stories to be told. So why am I jealous of a box of solid gold? And in my box there are things that I give out to whoever is about, in a small attempt to make somebody smile. In your box, well, you've better things to give, things that make people realize living is worthwhile. But my box will never have that kind of effect, cause the insides look kind of a wreck, and everything inside's wound up in tape and string. And in your box, well, everything's so neat, and even looking deep, I think you'll find it hard to find a broken thing. But I don't care that I'm carrying a box of broken parts, cause I regard the things inside as little works of art. And underneath the sellotape are great stories to be told. So why am I jealous of a box of solid gold? I gave my box to the most amazing girl, the kind that makes the world go round and round. But your box was already in her hands, and it was too much to withstand, and so she dropped my box and it fell to the ground. And the lid, it came up as the box fell to the pavement, and all my things, they shattered on the floor. But looking at the mess, I didn't feel much less. Oh, in fact, I felt much freer than before. But I don't care that I'm no longer carrying a box, cause it means my arms now feel the breeze and I swing them as I walk. And I hope for real that your box isn't difficult to hold, cause it must be fucking heavy carrying all that solid gold. Of sand are dots when they're stood up against rocks, easily washed over and easily forgot. But with pockets full of pebbles, find it hard to float. Swell shed off the skin of stone, favour of building a boat, and I'm gonna sail till I run out of sea, and I'm gonna sail across flowers with the bees, and I'm gonna sail high among the trees, and I'm gonna sail till it's impossible to see me anymore, until I appear all very small, till I am nothing more than a dot washed up on the shore. Thank you. probably just nothing, but I thought I heard a buzzing, and I think that there's a bee in my room. I don't know how she got in, there's no doors or windows open, but hopefully she'll find a way out soon. It's not that I am frightened, I just worry that she'll die in here. My room is not an ideal place to be. There isn't food inside her, but there's definitely spiders, so I really hope that soon she will be free. Oh little bee, just keep trying and be brave. Soon you will be free, don't make the windowsill your grave. Now I hope that she is fine and that she hasn't seen the flies that are dead and lying on the windowsill. Cause it's such an awful sight that it could fill her full of fright, or at the very least and make her feel quite ill. And if she starts to panic, it could make her actions manic, then escaping would be much more difficult. And if she's bouncing off the walls, it would be easier to fall, and she'd become a crippled bee as a result. Oh little bee, just keep trying and be brave. Soon you'll be free, don't make the windowsill your grave. Now I really can't be certain, but right there on the curtain, oh I think I saw a spider climbing up. And if the bee's inside the curtain that the spider's climbing, then the spider will be having her for lunch. But I hope that if she's caught, then she can turn it into sport, and that she's not the sort to fall without a fight. And she'll send the spider spinning with just one flap of her wings, and then she'll effortlessly find her way back out. Oh little bee, just keep trying and be brave. Soon you will be free, don't make the windowsill your grave. Now I no longer hear a buzzing, but it's probably just nothing, and there probably wasn't even a bee. Just the sound of some machine teamed up with my imagination, but even still I hope that she got free. Ago, and the notebook I carried was red. No holes in my jeans and a whole lot of dreams in my head. Sat on a train with my life in a bag by my feet, and the music in my headphones making me one with the sea. Watching the windows changing the form of the land, trees turn to buildings and pavements rise up from the sand. The smells of the city seep in through the holes in the wall, fill my nose with adventure like nothing that I've smelt before. But it's now 2 years later and my head is stuck in this frame. Sat at a window sill racing the droplets of rain. But the drops, they have stopped and don't look like they'll start up again. And I'm just sat at a window wishing I was back on that train. The back of the bus is flooded with light from the sun, shedding light on my head and the memories of things that I've done. Heading west at a guess on this road, cause who knows where it ends. It may lead to success, it may lead to the bestest of friends. It may lead to danger, it may lead to a hole in the ground. But that's the adventure, so wherever I'm led, oh, I'm bound. Sounds of the bus make vibrations that I feel inside. A rumble in the left of my chest that means I'm alive. But it's now 2 years later and my head is filling with dust. Sat at a windowsill racing the droplets of mist. But the drops, they have stopped and it looks like they've had enough. And I'm just sat at a window wishing I was back on that bus. took the posters and photographs down from my wall. Put them in a pile with the rest of my things on the floor. And I put down the seats, made them flat in the back of Dad's car. Unpiled on top all the things I would need for the year. And as we took to the road, took one last look at where I grew up. At the trees and the mountains, the school and the pump and the shop. We talked as we drove, and we made jokes and we laughed. As we took the piss out of the big army trucks that we passed. The sun it was shining, oh, as the car came to a slow. And we pulled up outside of a place I would call home. But it's now 2 years later and I'm stuck hugging a guitar. Sat at a window sill racing drops lit up by stars. But the drops they have stopped despite not even getting that far. And I'm just sat at a window wishing I was back in that car. But it's now 2 years later and my head is stuck in this frame. Sat at a window sill racing the droplets of rain. But the drops they have stopped and don't look like they'll start up again. And I'm just sat at a window wishing I was back in that car, on that bus, on that bike, on that plane, on the back of that horse, on that train. On that train. Thank you.